Behind the beauty of these mountains, a battle is being fought between modernity and tradition. This area has a maternal mortality rate of up to 10 times higher than other parts of the country. In order to save lives, ancient birthing practices must give way. 20-year-old Ying is from the Hmong ethnic group. She is one of 49 ethnic minority women who have recently graduated from a program targeting maternal and infant health in the region. But for Ying to succeed in her work as a midwife, she must overcome the obstacles of cultural tradition, politics, remoteness, and poverty. Ying's home is Chica Commune, a group of villages in the rural far north of the country, mostly populated by the Hmong. The district hospital is a 3-hour drive away. This means for the 2,500 locals, Chica's basic health centre is the only place to get medical attention. Over the last year, only a very small number of women in Chica gave birth at the local health centre, whilst 70% of women chose a traditional birth at home. Because ethnic women are much more likely to have home births, newborns in the rural mountains are 50% more likely to die than in the city. Ying is herself an ethnic Hmong and is caught between these two worlds. In order to reduce deaths, she must convince Chica's women to overcome their fear of the government-run health centre, yet respect the traditional values of her own culture.
Let's go.
Ying arrives at Sa's village. Sa lives with her husband and his family, who are on a break from working in the field. In Vietnam, ethnic minority women are four times more likely to die during childbirth. This figure rises amongst women like Sa, who are under the age of 18. In Hmong society, women marrying as young as 14 is common. One of the many reasons Hmong women prefer home births is so they can perform an important and ancient ritual. These customs make it difficult for Ying to convince women to give birth at the health center. The next day, Ying returns to Sa's village. Now she must get past Sa's husband and father in order to take her back to Chica. Having convinced the family, Ying and Sa begin their journey back to Chica, but on their way must stop at another village. Ying's sister-in-law, 22-year-old Pang, is also 9 months pregnant. Pang chose to give birth to her first two children at home.
Ying's sister-in-law, 22-year-old Pang, is also 9 months pregnant. Begin with the Jan. La la, you're the sweetie.
Don't worry.
Lulu thấy điện cho dù nha, giờ tôi cho dù nha.
Tôi thích đó gì nè.
Ồ. Tỏ phèn.
Ơ, cái tầm mà lên chứ.
Tớ chứ hả tầm mà, cái xe kia lúc chứ tớ nó tớ chứ chờ sâu xa. Thả hả, dù hồ, hồ chơi tao, cái xe nó cần chân sao cỡ đó nó cần tôi tổ tổ chứ sinh tổ mà tổ à, ở đây cần bác khách bên mà được chưa?
Ying guides Pang and Sa on a 7-kilometer journey towards the Chica Health Center.
Tôi có đi chút xa cả.
Đi chút xa.
There is a high chance that one of them could give birth at any time. And there is an added danger. The hike takes them along the borderline of Vietnam and China. In recent years, this area has seen a massive rise in the kidnapping of Hmong women by Chinese sex traffickers. At the Chica Health Center, Pang and Sa nervously await their checkups. Their unease stems from a history of tension between the Vietnamese state and the 700,000-strong Hmong community. A communist policy of assimilation in the 1970s and 80s has left its mark, and a distrust of the government remains. As part of her job, Ying must ease this tension by acting as a translator between Hmong women and Vietnamese health workers.
Bảo có nhưng mà không cái đưa đi. Bảo sợ anh không đồng ý đeo đi. Có cháu đi bảo chắc khó.
Nghỉ bây giờ nghỉ xong là sáng mai bảo đồng đeo đi đường ngoài đi kìa, không sóc.
The health center can't give Pang the full examination she needs. So tomorrow, she will have to make a 6-hour return journey to the district hospital for an ultrasound. But for now, she'll stay at her parents' home near the health center, whilst Sa also goes to stay with relatives nearby.
Tôi sẽ nhớ tập là tây nhìn tất cả nhớ tòa nhiều hơn lý lệ.
The next day, Pang returns from her trip to the district hospital. With a birth imminent, there is no choice now but for Pang to return to her mother's house and wait. Later, and Pang is now in labor. She must walk for 30 minutes in the dark to get to the health center. If Pang gives birth now, it could be fatal.
Chú
After 4 hours of labor, Ying has helped safely deliver the baby. But the danger remains for Pang. In a condition known as uterine inertia, her uterus is failing to contract normally, causing a delay in the delivery of her placenta. This is Vietnam's number one cause of maternal death. But this time, Pang is lucky. Finally, the placenta is delivered.
Từ hôm cô hồi kém là cháu phải ở nhà để theo dõi, nhé. Mai anh em nữa không được đi nhà và theo dõi cháu ở đây nữa thì mới theo dõi không là để mà tử cung nó không có hồi tốt là nó băng huyết là chết. Hôm nay không có cơ hướng đi chợ mà ở nhà. Vào trước thì mình nhé.
By not having a home birth, Ying has convinced the family to break with centuries of cultural practice. Even so, the Vietnamese doctors allow Pang's husband to carry out a modified version of the most important Hmong birthright. Pang named her newborn daughter after Ying. A few days later, Sa decided to return to her village and, assisted by her mother-in-law, gave birth to a boy at home. Across the globe, over 300,000 women die each year in childbirth, 99% in developing countries like Vietnam. Ying has played her own small part in reducing that figure, and in order to save more lives, she must continue to walk the fine line between tradition and modernity. For Ying, the challenge continues.